I've waited 4 years for this moment to be able to stand up in front of you, look you in the eyes, and say we made money. So finally that opportunity is here. I've been getting sleep because of it. Not having to worry any longer about what our worst case scenario may be, and believe me, our staff had a lot of those worries. I'm not sure how much irony there is in making a profit in a year where everybody else lost money, or where other businesses failed, laid off employees, closed locations. I mean, we certainly have seen way too much of that here in our local economy. And back last January, we were facing the same thing at Outpost. With our sales down at that point by 5% from the year before, we were looking layoffs straight in the eyes. What I'm happy to say is that with the exception of one person who we actually called back to work 4 months later, we did not have to lay off any employees of Outpost. In fact, we did something I think pretty extraordinary that a lot of other businesses never considered doing. We asked our employees for help. And guess what? It worked. So, before we posted the profit that Terry just explained to you in the financial statements today, we were able to pay back half of what everybody had given up over this last year. And I think that is important. So it is with great appreciation, and I see a lot of our employees today, people from our stores and people from our offices. I truly, once again, do this without crying. Thank you from the bottom of my heart for everything that you've done, because you truly make this cooperative the wonderful place that it is. There really is a lot of love in this co-op. We see it on Facebook every day, from the tweets on Twitter that we receive, and the newspapers for house and our store. People can't, they just want to hold up those signs that say, I love Outpost. And I wonder why. I mean, what's so different about us than any other business in town? Why all this love? Well, if you want my opinion, and I get to give it to you because I'm the one at the microphone right now, I think it's because we are the real deal. I mean, this is real, it's authentic. You have people volunteering their time up here in the front of the room to make sure this co-op stays on track. You've got people sacrificing their wages to make sure this co-op stays on track. We don't need marketing gimmicks to show people who we are. We know the names of our farmers and our local vendors by name. We know about their families, we know about their animals. We probably know a lot more at times than we choose to know. But that's what really matters, and that's what's real. And you don't find a lot of real out in the world today, which is unfortunate. But I think we can create a lot of real, and we've got it right here in this room today. We run our business honestly. We admit to our mistakes when we make them. We listen to our employees, we listen to our owners, we listen to our customers and our community. And if every business would just slow down and do that, I think we'd have a lot more love here in Milwaukee. So, I for one want to make this world a better place. That's why I've been working at Outpost for the past 29 years. And after all, what Peter said earlier is really true. We exist so that our owners have a healthy, diverse, and sustainable community. That's the board's ultimate vision for the co-op and for the city of Milwaukee and our surrounding communities. And it's mine too. So thank you for coming out today and for loving Outpost as much as I do.